Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to show you the new Designer's Choice die set, and I'm going to make three sets with different color schemes, and I will show you some fun and not obvious ways to use the dies. Here are all the parts I cut for the square box, and I have layers for all sides. You can do it in one layer too, just make them to your own taste. I'm going to glue the glitter piece to a piece of vellum that I cut with the dies too. I use glue and this dries clear so it will not be visible. On the back I add the glue on the part where the die cut shape is as much as possible. And again it will dry clear, but I like to work neat, if that's the right word, so the opposite of messy. And then I add it to the panel and I let the light shine through so I can add it on the pattern. And I do the other panels in the same way. I fold it and add it tape to the flaps and then I add them together. After I added the panel, I burnished with the Precision Glide so it sticks really well. And just so you know, I added the main products I used in the description box for you. You can also find the full list of supplies on my blog. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. And now the last seam. And because it's square, you can fold it flat. And then I add a square on top and the top part is done. For the box part I cut the panels and hearts with vellum hearts and I glue the parts like I did for the top. I show you here how you can fold the flaps. Easiest is to do it when they are on your work surface. And I use the Precision Glide to burnish. I add a tape to the flaps and now I assemble the box. Just add the panels and line them up at the top. And then you can fold it flat again to add the parts together. And then I add the bottom and I do this just corner by corner. And then I burnish and it will be assembled in no time. So here are the parts ready and the top can go on the box. I wiggle the little openings a bit, but it actually goes pretty smooth in the first take. So here's the finished square box. And with the same dies you can also make the cutest pocket. I cut two panels and then I use the same die to cut out the opening. I line it up with the edge of the die and die cut and on the pretty side of the paper. And then I run it through the machine again and then I get a little almost round shape. And I use that again on the back of the panel, because there the inside shows. And I glue it to the top on the inside to give it a nice finish. I added tape to the flaps and now I assemble the pocket. And then I burnish for a pretty finish. I added a little heart to the top and glued the hearts together. And now I'm going to add a white heart to the back. I cut it in half and already added tape to the back of the glitter heart. And I add the halves to the back, sticking out a bit on both sides. And then I add tape to the back and add it on the pocket. And you can use this for a mini card or a name placeholder. Next I have a card. I cut the shape out of the card four times and this has the sentiment in it. I cut that part again out of glitter card and you can use a scrap piece for this. And now I cut away the bits around the word. And then I glue that in place. I have another word that I cut apart and that fits right on the heart. I glued it in place first and I cut off the excess bits. And then I add the heart to the white heart. I added the card with the parts cut out to a white card and I add a complete piece to a teal card base. I add the squares together, there's already tape on the back, and then I add the piece to the card. I add the heart in the middle with glue, and I finish with a bunch of flowers in all the colors I used for the card. And here's the first set with the different options in matching colors. It's fun to make sets like this for a party or as a gift for someone special. For the next box, I have cut the parts out of white, red and red glitter, and I glued the parts together for the tops and added the panels, like I showed you for the first box. And now I'm going to assemble the top, and then I burnish the seam. And this one is the easiest to assemble as the little flaps stick together. And the triangle fits just right on. Easy peasy. For the box, I glued the parts in place and I added the panels. I lined the parts up at the top of the panels and I burnish again. And then I add the bottom. And my box is done. Now I can add the top and it fits right on. And I made another little pocket to match. Let's make another card. I used the panel die to cut out of the glitter card and I'm going to cut off the little flaps. I line it up along the straight side and I use the trimmer to cut off the pieces. I lay out all the parts on the white card to see where I need to glue them. And then I add them on the card. And I add the hearts in the same way. Added a complete piece to a red card base, and here's the red and white set, with some more fun ways to use the dies. And then the last box with all parts cut, I added the parts together again. I added the 5 panels with tape, and now I'm going to assemble the last part. I removed all the backing pieces of the tape, and I add the last parts together. And then I add the shape on top. I burnish the inside so it all sticks really well. And then I assemble the box. I taped all the panels together and now I add the last part. And then I add the bottom piece. And then I can add the top to the box and another box is done. I added a little flower on top as a fun touch. And now the card. Again, I cut all the parts and I'm going to add the layers. First some basic layers of color, and then I have a piece with the hearts cut out. And I'm going to add white heart to the back, this way it stands out a bit more. And I did the same on the other corners. I added the piece to the card. I cut a bunch of hearts and glued them together to get some dimension. I add a bit of shiny copper color thread. And this is something I should have done before, but I changed plans while crafting yet again. So I used the craft pick to help get the thread under the layer. And then I tape the hearts in place. And I finish with a little flower I had cut for my initial plan. So here's the third set together. I hope I inspired you to get crafty yourself. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and make sure to keep on crafting!